2 weeks ago, Hurricanes forward Isaiah Walker-Leawere was banned from sport for a month after testing positive for THC, the main psychoactive compound found in cannabis. That's despite drug-free sport New Zealand admitting it's not performance enhancing and that they're campaigning against its prohibited status in sport. However, as Victor Waters explains, the plant's medicinal use is gaining support within rugby.
He's a familiar face in New Zealand rugby. Now Liam Messam wants to be the face of change for player welfare. Pushing for cannabidiol, or CBD, the therapeutic component of cannabis, to be embraced.
I tried it and absolutely loved it straight away. Just the inflammation in the body, the best sleeps that I've had. Doesn't cure the problem, it just, you know, helps me live a better life.
Its use by rugby players has risen since 2018 when it was removed as a banned substance by the World Anti-Doping Authority. But cannabis itself is still banned. And while drug-free sport is fighting that, it has concerns about contamination and prescription-only CBD.
CBD, it doesn't have the psychoactive piece to it, and is used medicinally properly to cope with a bunch of with pain relief, with some stress disorders. And you need to be really clear as an athlete that it doesn't have any residual THC in it. And as an athlete, how do you know that?
Instead, athletes currently turn to painkillers, ranging from anti-inflammatories to opioids. Among those, tramadol, which from next January will be banned by WADA in competition after concerns over its addictive potential.
I made a couple of friends here at the Chiefs when they were playing because they had to take Voltarens just to be able to play. Took too many one night, and then his wife found him collapsed over the toilet seat and had a couple of ulcers in his stomach. When you're a young footy player, all you want to do is get out there on the footy field and you're doing whatever it takes.
Former Blues and Scotland player Grayson Hart knows that all too well. A knee injury forcing him to take up to 8 painkillers a day for 3 years while playing. It led him to create the first CBD product on the market certified by WADA.
There are so many players just hugely reliant on painkillers, and it's so unhealthy. I see CBD as a way to show the wider world that this kind of narrative that we've got against something like the cannabis plant isn't all that it's kind of portrayed to be.
Yeah, there's a lot of interest within the rugby circles about CBD. This is one of those things that they're too scared to take it.
But with organisations like the NBA and UFC now allowing cannabis, CBD could soon be a game changer in sport. Victor Waters, One News.